Let's assume that we have a single autonomous system with static link weights, as shown. In such a setup, routers will flood information to one another to learn the network topology, including the link weights, on links connecting individual routers. An operator can affect how traffic flows through the network by configuring the link weights. By changing the link weight configuration, an operator can affect the shortest path between two points in this graph, thus affecting the way that traffic flows. In the link weight setting shown here, traffic would flow along the green path. Suppose that the operator would like to shift traffic off of a congested link in the middle of the network, such as this one. By changing the link weight from 1 to 3, the shortest path between this node and this node now takes an alternate route. So we can see from this simple example that by adjusting the link weights in an intra-domain topology, the operator can affect how traffic flows between different points in the network, thus affecting the load on the network links. In practice, network operators set these link weights in a variety of ways. One could set the link weights inversely proportional to capacity, proportional to propagation delay, or the operator might perform some network-wide optimization based on traffic.